A very good morning to all of you. So we'll be starting our lecture today. We would be having 10 questions that we would be discussing based on the reading comprehension passage. So we would have three passages, one based on environment, science and ethics. So there would be three passages on different themes. We have already provided the link where you have the passages. So if you are having a strain reading the passages here, there goes the link. You can just go on to the link, read the first paragraph, and we'll have the questions here. Meantime, while you start reading the passage, I'll be just discussing something. So just go through the passage. Based on every passage, we would be having the question answers that we would be discussing. Now, this reading comprehension is a very important part for your UPSC, that's IAS examination, the CSET paper 2, which is qualifying, a very difficult task for most of the students from Hindi medium background and regional backgrounds rather. Again, for students appearing for the NET examination, for bank PO examination, for IBPS, SSC, all of these exams have reading comprehension as an integral part of your paper. So if you have good command, you can definitely work on the questions very well. So just go through this passage, understand the passage. Also, we would be having classes every Tuesday and Thursday at 10:30 a.m. in the morning, which would be the testing Tuesdays and testing Thursdays. On Tuesdays, we would bring the topics related to aptitude, quant, reasoning. On Thursdays, we would have topics related to the GK, the core social studies, history, geography, polity, and so on. So let's go ahead with the passage and understand the intricacies. Now, this passage is a passage that talks about environmental awareness and environmental issues rather. Over the past years, we have seen a rising trend on the kinds of paragraphs that are coming for your reading comprehension, focusing a lot on science technology development, focusing a lot on environmental awareness, and also specifically for your CSET, you would have ethical passages that are there, because this forms a background for your GS paper 4 for your mains examination. So this passage has been focusing on the idea of ocean cleanup. Now, based on this passage, we would have three questions. So the first question is here. Now, what is very important, we don't have the answer below the question, so don't get confused. It's the section from the passage which would provide the answer for this question. And this is the strategy that we would have for all the questions that we would be discussing here. So whenever you are writing your answers in the comment, please mark the question number and the answer so that it becomes easier for us and other students to comprehend which question you are targeting on. So there is the first question. The size of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is compared to which of the American state? Now, from the whole paragraph that we saw in the previous slide, you have the first paragraph that has the answer for it. So we have the snippet for the first paragraph here and waiting for the answer. So yes, a lot of you have got confused here. Lot of you putting up the answer as B. Just read the paragraph carefully. I again request you to read the passage carefully. Just the first paragraph and come up with the answer. Yes, Rehmat and Satya has the right answer, and lot of right answers now. So this is a stretch of plastic floating between California and Hawaii. So that's very, very important. It's between California and Hawaii. But the question says it is of the size, and the size is compared to which state, which is present in the last line. So size is compared to the double the size of Texas in America. So Texas is the correct answer here. I hope that makes the section very, very clear. So don't do it very quickly. Just read for a while. The patch lies between California and Hawaii, but the size of the patch is twice as compared to the size of Texas. So if you look on to the question here, you would have the very well understanding of the concept here, which is present in the last line. Clear? I hope this section is clear. So be very careful while reading the question. The next question is, what can be said about the Ocean Cleanup Organization from the passage? Now we have the section of the passage that would indicate the answer. However, for this section, it was a bit tricky to find out from what exact section you would be having the answer. But just to have the things streamlined here, we have the passage, the section of the passage which is targeting the answer. So just read the section of the passage again and try to express the answer here. Please mark, I request again, please mark the question number along with the answer so that we have the right indication. So lot of you are still coming up with the answers for question 1. So question 1, the correct answer is Texas. Back to question 2. Still not clear, okay. Lot of incorrect answers coming up. Still waiting for the correct answer. All of the above is not a correct answer here. If you read this passage, the section of the passage that has been put here, just read it carefully again. Satya has the right answer, Priya, right? So the correct answer is, we have, it has done the decades of research. Now how do we understand this? There is nothing being talked about the affiliation to US in the whole paragraph, the whole comprehension passage. Not just this section of the passage, but the whole passage, we are not indicating to the affiliation to US. We are also not talking about the green startup. So these two points are obviously not part of the answer. Now, if you look onto the fourth line of this passage, the founder of the organization stated that plasticine going back to 1960s and 70s. So that means we have done a decade of research indicating how long the plastic has been there. And therefore, we can say B is the correct choice. So again, I request you to read the question, read the passage very, very carefully. And answer should be solely on the basis of the passage. Okay? I hope this is clear. Let's move on to the last question for this passage. So just read the last question, question 3, looking for the correct answer. Again, I request you the same thing. The answers are based on the content given in the passage. The Sisyphean task indicates what? Looking for the correct answer for question number 3, just read this section of the passage that we have marked here. Okay, great. A lot of correct answers for question 3 and lot of confusions also. So let's discuss this again. Just go to the fourth line again. So you have a myth of a task never completed. And therefore, task which never completes is a Sisyphean task. We are not saying it has to be repeated again and again. Okay. The passage clearly indicates that the task which is not being able to complete, or Sisyphean is a word, is a Greek myth which talks about the task which is never completed. So directly from the passage, the fourth line of the passage, we have the right answer here. Okay. So the correct answer for this would be D. Clear? Okay. Let's move on to the next passage. Now this passage is related to blood transfusion, how the story of blood transfusion evolved, what were the things that initially started and what were the developments that took place later, how initial developments were done. And this is a passage which is related to science and technology. So science and technology, as we said, is an important section. So either you can just go through and read the passage here, or you can read the passage in the link that we have provided for the website. So you can just go on to the Examrace website and read the passage, whichever is convenient to you. The link is also available in the description below the video. So just check that. In the meantime, while you are reading, also we would be starting a daily 5 questions for your GK, which would be very important based on contemporary developments as well as the basic core topics of social studies. Very important for your UPSC and other competitive examinations. So daily there would be 5 questions coming up, and on Friday we would be discussing the explanations for those 5 questions. Very, very important. So just check those sections, check those kind of questions that are part of your UPSC, and this would be done till your prelims examination is there. Okay, so I hope by now you have completed the passage, reading the passage. So let's move on to the question. So here is the first question based on the second passage. What can be known about the blood transfusion in the early 19th century? And here is the excerpt from the passage which is relevant to this answer. So based on this passage, just try to find out which section would be most relevant, or what answer would be the correct answer. So I'm looking for the correct answers for question number 4. Looking for the correct answers. Jyoti B is not the correct answer. I learned with Devraj, right? You have C as the correct answer. Now, how do you got C as the correct answer? Good going. So you have, from storing the blood in bottles to plastic pouches and discovering the compatibility with the blood groups, testing for infection, blood transfusion has evolved significantly. That means what was the most primitive thing that was known was storing. Okay, so blood storage was primitive. That's correct. The blood groups were known, that is incorrect, because that has evolved historically. It's clearly written, compatibility with the blood groups have evolved. Okay, so this is not correct. Blood transfusion was continuous, that is also not correct, because in the last sentence we have the ounce of the blood, the 14 ounce of the blood were administered by the syringe in the small amounts. So they were administered in the small amounts, that means it was not continuous. So B is also incorrect. So you have C as the correct option here. I hope that's clear. Okay, great. So since 1 and 2, A and B are incorrect, D cannot be the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. What is true regarding the duo of Blundell and Noyes? So you have the paragraph, the section of the paragraph that indicates the correct answer. So just read this section of the paragraph and bring the correct answer for question number 5. Waiting for the correct answers for question number 5. I hope it's clear. Most of the content, as we said, is directly applicable from the passage. There is a request to repeat the fourth question again. Okay, so those who are reading the fifth question can continue. In the meanwhile, just the fourth question, repetition of that. The second line, from storing blood in glass bottles to plastic pouches and discovering compatibility to testing infections and blood transfusion, has evolved significantly. That means the most primitive thing that was known was storing the blood. Later on, what came was the compatibility with blood groups, testing for infections, blood transfusion. Okay, so everything came later. So blood groups were not known during that time. So A becomes the incorrect option. And in the last sentence, we have talked about that 14 ounces of blood was administered by the syringe in small amounts. So you administer by syringe gets empty, you administer it again. That means it was not a continuous process. So blood transfusion was continuous is again incorrect. The only correct statement that remains is C, that is blood storage was primitive. I hope that's clear. Okay, back on to the fifth question. Fifth question, which is true? So just read the question carefully. It's not asking which is false. The question says which is true. Lot of incorrect answers coming up. Okay, so let me discuss this, which is true regarding the DO. Now, the first thing that was done by both the scientists was applying it to a 35-year-old man who was suffering from what is presently called as gastric carcinoma, named something different during that time. Okay. Now, this patient died 56 hours later. That means this was not successful. So, the first blood transfusion was successful becomes an incorrect statement. Okay, so first cannot be the correct statement. The second statement explains, Blundell described his first transfusion was with the patient having gastric carcinoma. Again, this is incorrect because Noyes and Blundell did not know the term gastric carcinoma. That is, of present we call it gastric carcinoma. They had a separate term for this, and this term was mentioned in the passage here. Okay. So that was how they described it. So that statement again becomes incorrect. And the last statement was all their achievements were unpublished. That's also incorrect because in the last line it says the second case was published in Lancet in 1829. So all of those three are not correct. Okay. I hope that's clear. So, Rehmat has the right answer, Priya has the right answer. Good going, Rehmat and Priya. Okay, so this was the second question on the second passage. Now, moving on to the third question on the second passage. A very small section of the passage I have taken here, and that would itself indicate the correct answer. So, just check the question number 6. Looking for the correct answers for question number 6. Question number 6, what would be the correct answer? Great. So, Mahendra has the right answer. Ehlis, you can read the passages on the link that we have provided. So, we have provided willingly the link on a separate section. So, you can just go onto the website and read the passage again. Lot of you have confusion with question number 5. So, let me, Saurav, again, we have the link there. Please read the passages on those links. You have 3 passages. All of those passages are provided on the Exam Race website. Please refer the link to read the passages if you are having issues with the passages here. Okay, let me repeat the question number 5 again. And then we'll come on to the question number 6 back. Question number 5, I repeat again, the first blood transfusion was not successful because the patient died 56 hours later. So A is incorrect. The second choice, which says Blundell describes his first transfusion patient as having gastric carcinoma, was also incorrect because they didn't knew the term gastric carcinoma. It is now called as gastric carcinoma. Okay, so that's again incorrect. All of their publications went unpublished. That's again incorrect from the last line. That was the case was published in Lancet in 1829. So the case was published in Lancet in 1829. And therefore, this is again incorrect. The C choice is again incorrect. Okay. I hope that's clear. Question number 5. Coming on to question number 6. The urgent need for regulatory attention is important, because the second sentence clearly says this is happening only because government has made zero efforts to put a system in place. And since there is no effort by the government or zero effort by the government, we can say there is a need for urgent regulatory attention to check out the risk by transmission that could take place. Okay. So you have, sorry. B as the correct answer. Now, a lot of you have mentioned D as a correct answer. Why D cannot be a correct answer? Because limited in technological progress, it's nowhere mentioned that we are limited in the technological progress, and it is a safe procedure. So we have not talking and we have not touched the issue of the safety here. Okay, the only thing that we know here is government is not taking any effort to work on this issue, and therefore there is a need for an urgent regulatory attention. I hope that's clear. Vijaya has a question here for older current affairs. So older current affairs are available in the exam race section. You can just go there and refer those. And also you have to refer last 2.5 years or like past 2 to 3 years, Yojana and Kurukshetra. We have the playlist where you can find those, or you can refer the magazines itself. Okay? Hope that's clear. The last paragraph, and this paragraph is based on ethics, very, very important for the students appearing for CSET examination. Ethics is a very major section and many of the questions are there from ethics every time. Okay? So just read this passage carefully. I'll have few minutes for you to read this passage. Once you are done reading this passage, you can read it on the link provided. It's there in the description. You have the 3 passages that are provided on the website. Now, since this is an ethical passage, it becomes a pretty confusing and a pretty, I would say, important section for, as I said, UPSC, not also UPSC, but also your IBPS examination. IBPS has a changing trend these days and you have lot of ethical questions that are coming in. Passage link has again been provided, so those who are having difficulty reading the passage here can read it on the link provided here. Okay, let's move on to the question. So the first question is, how has Mr. He Jiankui work been received by the scientific community? Now this passage talks about ethical issues. The idea was, in China you had a researcher, He Jiankui, and he did a significant research where he developed world's first babies, which were pair of twin girls. They were genetically modified and they were immune to HIV or protected from HIV. However, this was not approved by ethical committee and therefore all this problem came in. It was expected that he would receive a lot of praise from the scientific community, but ultimately this was not the case. So question number 7, what would be the correct answer? Looking for the correct answers for question number 7. Great, so all of you have the right answer. I believe this was much more easier than the previous 2 passages. Okay, so D is the correct answer. And it's clearly mentioned in the last line, Mr. He has been condemned. Okay, so condemnation is the right answer here. The next question is, in the medical institutions, what is the role of ethics committee? So looking for the correct answers for next question, question number 8. A very good response for the first question for the last passage. Question number 8. Great, Mahendra, so you have the right answer here. In medical institutions, what is the role of ethics committee is regarding protocol enforcement and approving the research. Now, whenever you have any research, what happens is there are 2 ways under which you can think about it. One is the scientific developments and the other is the bureaucratic or the administrative procedure. So whenever there is a bureaucratic or an administrative procedure, for example, an ethics committee coming in, you would have to get the approval for the research, you would have the enforcement of the protocols that would come into light. And this is clearly explained in this passage. Okay, this section of the passage clearly explains the question. Great going for question number 8. A lot of you with the correct answers. Good, good. So let's move on to the next question. What does the statement ethical norms in science aren't framed in a higher moral plane means in the passage? So this is the section of the passage which we have here and this would indicate the correct answer for you. So looking for the correct answers for question number 9. Question number 9, waiting for the correct answers. This question talks about ethical norms in science aren't framed in a higher moral plane. Uh, looking for the correct answers for question number 9. Shahi, great. So you have the right answer, Shahi, here. So ethics in science is practical. It's not idealistic at all. So based on the funds that is coming in, the cash that is flowing in, you understand how you have to be practical in the ethical consideration. So reading the last sentence of the passage, you can understand it. What is permissible and ethical is also influenced by business research, concerns about among other countries, competitive advantage, and how medical advances have actually progressed. So therefore, we say ethics and science is very, very practical. So C becomes your correct answer. I hope that's clear. Wait, since it's a kind of reading comprehension passage and this channel is devoted to English students, please bear with us. We would be covering this only in English. For Hindi, we have a separate channel, which is Exam Race Hindi. You can just check out the Hindi section there. All the videos which are live here would be covered only in English. Okay, so just work based on the passage. Based on the passage, the last line itself, you have the correct answer. And the last question for today is, Sputnik 2.0 is used with reference to, looking for the correct answer for question number 10. Ravi Shankar has a question regarding live classes for NET. So these are the live classes for NET as well. So every Tuesday we would have the section that is common for your IAS CSET as well as NET. So the kind of questions would remain the same. You can join every Tuesday at 10:30. And the scheduled live classes, the dedicated live classes for NET would begin in the month of July. In the month of May, okay? Question number 10, the correct answer, Priya, great, Jyoti, good. So you have A as the correct answer. It's talking about, read the sentence here, and this talks about a biomedical duel on the progress between China and US, okay? So this statement itself explains a competition between United States and China. So A becomes your correct option. Now, some of you have been confused with B and D as the options, but B and D cannot be the option because shifting from military to scientific is not important, but because Sputnik was in space science, it was not related to military first of all, and it's not mentioned which countries are indicated here. Okay, so this cannot be the correct option, and the remaining two, again, the ethical issues have not been touched. It's just explaining that it's a biomedical duel on the progress between China and United States. Again, a very, very direct section from the passage itself. So read the passage very, 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 very carefully. So that's the passage. So it's just a kind of metaphor that has been used, an indicative that has been used. I understand that Sputnik was created by Russia. You are trying to indicate, Shahi, that. But this section has been used here as a trigger for the space wars that have been discussed. Okay. Hope that's clear. Okay, so good luck. We'll be meeting again on Thursday. We would be having Thursday with environment and geography, the basic topics. And on Tuesdays, we would be having the aptitude and the reasoning sections. Thursdays, we would be having the basic social sciences, current affairs, science and tech sections. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.